Shalom. This is Mary Omni from the World Government House of King David, Holy Covenant Constitutional Enforcer.
This is a Republic Notice. The title of this Republic Notice is called Donkey Tail Pinners Want President Obama Impeached. Donkey Tail Pinners Want President Obama Impeached. It's November 2013. President Obama's in his second term. And this is the anniversary of the first year of his second term as president and First Lady Michelle Obama as First Lady. And it seems to be the never-ending people who want to stir up a whole bunch of controversy about nothing. And after I finish talking, you'll understand why it's about nothing. They want to make a big deal out of everything he's doing. And so what I want to make clear to you is who these donkey tail pinners are. And once you understand these donkey tail pinners, you'll understand that why they are called racist, really. And this is why. You know how when you were a child, you played pin the tail on the donkey when you went to a party? You know, we had a lot of things as children to teach us lessons about life. One thing that was very vital to us was the Pledge of Allegiance. We did the Pledge of Allegiance, and it was to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all, to the Republic for which it stands. Now, donkey tail pinners always talk about public rights, public land, public this, public that, public this, public that. But if they're past the age of 40, and if they are the baby boomers, which make up the majority of the conservative Tea Party, they knew they grew up in a pledge of allegiance to the Republic, not the public that they put so much of their heart into and heart and soul into and talking about public rights and public this and public works and the public land, the public parks, the public this, the public that, their public rights, they pay public taxes, you know. So, you know, this Tea Party is just a name for basically a baby boomer generation whose privileges are now starting to dwindle as they see their chickens coming home to roost of the years that they voted second and third generations for a banking cartel and a military industrial complex that they all voted consent to just to maintain all white senators. It didn't matter whether they was foreign or corporate or, unconstitutional. The only thing that mattered is that they was all white and mostly all white males at that. Or now they're moving into all foreign. See, anything but that black constitutional citizen could have the Senate seats. See, you know, anything but a black man or a black woman who hold amendments in the Constitution. See, everybody had a chance. All the public was supposed to just govern the Republic Supreme Contract. The Supreme Contract of the Republic, black Americans and Ephraim heirs supposedly didn't have no intelligence or right to govern the contract they was in. So they'd rather go with unconstitutional contracts that fight the Republic. And this is why you hear a lot of them talking about, I pay public taxes, the public works, and this is a public park. I should be able to do this in the public, and this is the public broadcasting, public station, public YouTube, public Google, public this, public that, public this, public that. I want them to produce the Pledge of Allegiance to the public. Where's the Pledge of Allegiance to the public? I mean, baby boomers and the Tea Party, you didn't grow up with no, I pledge allegiance to the public. It was Pledge Allegiance to the Republic because the Republic is the Supreme Contract. And that's the land contract, the land governing contract. Okay, so now these donkey tail pinners, you want to stay in their childhood. And they want to think they're going to forever have their little privileged party and play musical chairs with this Supreme Contract. And they want to pretend that they're doing more than just pinning the tail on a donkey. The mule of 1871 called the U.S. Corporation, government of Washington, D.C., is the mule that came to blacks with their 40 acres. And it was for those types like the baby boomer now calling themselves the Tea Party, who wanted to pin the tail on the donkey because they didn't want to respect the Republic they took a pledge of allegiance to when they was children. So they didn't want to respect that. So that's why the mule was there for them to play in their abominations of desolation and keep going to this mule tail and pinning the donkey tail on the donkey. Pin the tail on the donkey, pin the tail on the donkey, pin the tail on the donkey, pin the tail on the donkey. Because that's where they are programmed and stratified at, to pin the tail on the donkey, because then they identify themselves only as abominator of desolation contractors in 10-mile radius, harnessed as debt bonders for the military industrial complex and the Federal Reserve. And that has been since 1913, since the Federal Reserve and the military industrial complex was developed under Woodrow Wilson, New Birth of a Nation. Now, these people in their 60s, who are baby boomers like President Clinton and people like that, you know, Motown tried to reach out to them, tried to get them into some cosmic rhythm. But as we can see, they danced off beat. But yet they wouldn't let black singers have black people dancing around them when they sing. It always had to be white stringy head or white women or white men, you know, dancing around these black singers. So as late as even the 60s and 70s or the late 60s, you see them playing this pentadel on a donkey, where they were satisfied with the constitutional republic being pushed aside so they can pin this tail on the donkey of the U.S. corporation of the 10-mile radius and stay stratified in that, because they didn't want to serve the constitutional republic they took and pledged allegiance to, just like their mothers and fathers before and grandmothers and fathers before, ever since 1913, Woodrow Wilson, Birth of a Nation. So they are identifying themselves that they pin the tail on the donkey, pin the tail on the donkey, pin the tail on the donkey, which means they are abominator of desolation contractors who are processed by the mule as debtors. They don't come near the Constitutional Republic. You know, their votes are votes of abomination or desolation, trapped in a 10-mile radius mule near the mule anus, where they stand in line to pin the tail on the donkey. They call themselves running to voting booths, but all they do is go pin the tail on the donkey, pin the tail on the donkey. And this donkey, abomination of desolation, donkey fuel and dung is burned for the military industrial complex and the bankers. So they are a mass of herd that pins the tail on the donkey, the burn abomination and desolation contracts for the military industrial complex and the banking cartel, to pretend that they have rights because they got these donkey dwellers always pinning the tail on the donkey and then talking about constitutional rights as if they're not stratified in 10-mile radius in near the mule anus. See, they don't even have the 10 full 10-mile radius. They just have enough room to pin their little tail on the donkey and indict themselves as embezzlers and thieves and abominators of desolations and generational thievership of fake and fronted privilege by majority trampling and, you know, military industrial complex supporting their trampling. And so when you get someone like President Obama, who is actually constitutional because he's married to a constitutional republic woman, and their blood has merged in that they have offspring that has put his blood in a constitution connected with hers ever since her people was written as 3/5. 3/5 equal to 8 of infinity. So that 8 of infinity is not going to be stratified. But yet the 8 of infinity was still a non-consenter because it was written as 3/5, even though the sum is infinity. 3/5 is a non-consenter, which means the republic, once blacks became legal constitutional citizen, they became legal non-consenters in the supreme contract of the republic. So that when those who did not want to serve that, they went and pinned the tail on the donkey, pinned the tail on the donkey. Now these donkey pinners, first response of defense is to say, oh, he just can't become a president by Michelle just because he married Michelle and they have children together. Do you not know what Article 2 says? And do you not know you're so ignorant to what goes on constitutionally? Yeah, that's their programming, that all blacks are ignorant. But this is the truth of it is. You don't have, as donkey pinners, no contract higher than Michelle Obama's. So you don't have no more authority over who the president becomes than she does or her people. So, you know, when you can produce a contract higher than Michelle Obama's and her people like in kind that she from, which is the black Americans with the 14th and 15th Amendment and the Constitution that was written as 3/5 investors at the beginning, you don't have no contract as a donkey tail pinners, Johnny come latelys, higher than Michelle Obama's. So therefore, you really don't have no authority over Article 2 either, because it's non-consenting jurisdiction. By legal non-consent, Article 2 is non-consented to donkey pinder. See, we don't mess with abomination dung. You know, our constitutional writers and reconstructionists' blood is on this contract. We had a lot of beautiful, beautiful, intelligent, genius men and women put this contract together. And their blood do not dwell with dung, abominations, and pin the tail on the donkey dwellers, okay? You know, you dwell near the donkey tail. As tea partiers, you pin the tail on the donkey. You run to booths and you wait for money and your all-white senates and all-white this and all-white corporate and foreign to fatten you up in privilege so the military industrial complex could use you as the excuse to steal and embezzle as they have done since Woodrow Wilson, okay? And they shared the stealing and embezzling with you, and they propped you up and they gave you your trinkets of, you know, your dung. Your dung dwelling and your donkey tail pinning, they gave you your little pins of gratitude with this little fiat money and made you think that you had some kind of constitutional rights that you never would get in 10 mile radius, because 10 mile radius don't have one amendment. An act is not an amendment. The amendments is the body of law that can nullify any act that it wants to, okay? So now these donkey tail pinners want President Obama impeached. And why? Because he didn't clean up enough of your donkey tail pinning reflex of that dung that came out every time you pinned the tail on the donkey, that the reflex of the dung came out. Yeah, it's a group of people who know that in America very well. They seeking privileges on that dung, and donkey tail pinning too. They seeking privileges trying to say, oh, we're entitled to the 14th. We got the right to move our dung, donkey tail pinning on the 14th. No, because you're not getting past the mule. And you're not getting past the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, New Jerusalem wall. You know, you can go here and steal with embezzlers and the globalists and get your last little trinkets in. And you can think that your embezzlers and your industrial complex and the globalists is enough to impeach President Obama because you say so. Because you say so and you scream while you pin the tail on a donkey with your all-white senates, your all-white bastions, your all-white schools, your all-white this, your all-white that, that you got for being donkey tail pinners, okay? Because you have no contract or nothing. So now while you find that you have no contract or nothing, you want to blame President Obama. But you and your kind have been pinning the tail on the donkey since 1913. Your parents did it, your grandparents did it, and Obama not the precious little dial-it you thought he was to clean up all your dung. He can't clean up your 100 years of dung when God gave you a contract to follow. And told you and programmed you and witnessed to each and all of y'all that y'all pledged allegiance to the Republic, okay? There was no pledge allegiance to the public, but all you tea and conservatives talk about is public rights, public this, public that, public this, public that. But you can't produce no pledge of allegiance to the public that was programmed in you. So, see, even with the programming of trying to save you, you had to go for your privilege of your white skin and whatever trinkets that you was offered as whores for the banksters, the gangsters, the globalists, and the military-industrial complex. So you need to know that you cannot impeach with a donkey pin and a donkey tail. All you can do is proclaim you have been impeached from any constitutionality since 1913.
This is Mary Omni from the House of King David. Shalom.